In this question, a bead of mass small m is attached to lower end of a light inextensible thread that passes through a small frictionless hole in a horizontal tabletop. The other end of the thread is held motionless. The bead is pulled aside and projected horizontally to move on a circular path of radius capital R with a speed V0 at a particular depth below the tabletop. Find work done in slowly pulling the thread upwards to reduce the depth of the circular path of the bead to half of its previous value. So it is important word here, the string is pulled slowly, the thread is pulled slowly. So when velocity is V0 and radius is R, then we can write the equations on this bead. टेंशन फोर्स विल एक्ट लाइक दिस, एम जी उस तरीके से लगेगा इस पर, एंड सपोज दिस एंगल इज थीटा, सो द हॉरिजॉन्टल कंपोनेंट ऑफ टेंशन विल प्रोवाइड द नेसेसरी सेंट्रीपेटल फोर्स, सो दिस कंपोनेंट विल बी इक्वल टू टी साइन थीटा, एंड द वर्टिकल कंपोनेंट विल बैलेंस एम जी, सो दिस इज टी कॉस थीटा. So writing the equations, T sin theta is providing the necessary centripetal force. So T sin theta is equal to mv naught square divided by the radius r, and T cos theta, this is equal to mg, and if we divide this two, then this is tan theta is equal to v naught square divided by this rg, and suppose this depth is equal to h, then tan theta we can write, this is r and this is h, so tan theta is equal to this tan theta is equal to, in this triangle this is r by h, so tan theta is r by h, so v naught square divided by rg, and what is this h here, this h is equal to r square g divided by v naught square, so this is the value of h initially. And in this expression, capital R is known, V naught is known, all the things are known, so we can find the value of H initially. And now it is given that ki isko slowly pull kar rahe hain, we are pulling it slowly. So agar isko slowly pull kar rahe hain, then we can assume ki har ek instant pe, jaise radius yahan par small hoti chali jayegi, iski jo radius hogi, radius will become smaller, and at each instant it is performing a uniform kind of circular motion विद ए न्यू स्पीड, तो इसकी स्पीड चेंज होती चली जाएगी, तो वर्टिकल डायरेक्शन में इसका जो मोशन होगा दैट इज़ ऑलमोस्ट विद नेग्लिजिबल स्पीड, ऊपर की तरफ इसका जो मोमेंट है वो मोमेंट हम एक तरीके से नेग्लिजिबल स्पीड के साथ अज्यूम करेंगे, और हर एक स्टैंड पे इसी तरीके का मोमेंट होगा, बस रेडियस एंड वेलोसिटीज विल बी डिफरेंट, सो रेडियस एंड वेलोसिटीज एंड दिस हाइट विल बी डिफरेंट. तो हर एक स्टैंड पे वी कैन राइट दिस फोर्स बैलेंसिंग इक्वेशंस, तो इनको हम यहाँ पर लिख सकते हैं. तो अगर किसी पर्टिकुलर इंस्टेंट पे, सपोज इट इज़ लाइक दिस, रेडियस सपोज अगर स्मॉल आर हो जाता है, और जो हाइट है सपोज अगर वो एस डैश हो जाती है, या एस डैश हमें यहाँ पर एच बाई टू लेना है, वी हैव टू टेक दिस हाइट एज एच बाई टू, एंड दिस वेलोसिटी इज इक्वल टू वी, जो स्पीड है वो यहाँ पर चेंज होती चली जाएगी, तो स्पीड विल बी चेंज्ड. तो इस तरीके का जो रिलेशन है वो फर्दर भी होल्ड करेगा, वी कैन राइट दिस काइंड ऑफ इक्वेशंस एंड दिस रिलेशन विल होल्ड. सो व्हेन हाइट इज़ एच बाई टू, रेडियस बिकम्स स्मॉल आर, दिस इज़ आर स्क्वायर जी डिवाइडेड बाय वी नॉट स्क्वायर, सॉरी फॉर वी नॉट वी कैन राइट वी स्क्वायर, सिंस वेलोसिटी इज़ वी, सो वेलोसिटी इज़ वी एंड रेडियस इज़ आर. इन दिस एक्सप्रेशन आर इज़ अननोन एंड दिस स्मॉल वी इज़ अननोन, we need one more equation. तो इसमें अगर we can, if you look carefully, तो इस bead पर जो लगने वाले forces हैं, one is tension, one is mg. There are two forces acting on this bead, one is tension and one is mg. And about this axis, ये जो axis है जिसके about यहाँ पर इसका circular motion हो रहा है, तो about this axis of rotation, mg का torque zero हो जाएगा, because mg is parallel to this axis. So mg is parallel to the axis. सो इसका जो टॉर्क होगा वो जीरो हो जाएगा, तो एम जी इज़ ऑलवेज पैरेलल टू द एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन, So torque due to mg about the axis will be zero. And tension, जो टेंशन है वो टेंशन हमेशा एक्सिस को ऑब्वियस है कि कट करेगा, तो टेंशन विल ऑलवेज कट द एक्सिस. सो टी कट्स द एक्सिस, टेंशन कट्स द एक्सिस. तो इसके वजह से भी जो टॉर्क आएगा दैट टॉर्क इज़ ज़ीरो. तो इसका मतलब एक्सिस के अबाउट कोई टॉर्क नहीं है, देर इज़ नो टॉर्क अबाउट द एक्सिस. तो वी कैन कंजर्व इट्स एंगुलर मोमेंटम, वी कैन कंजर्व द एंगुलर मोमेंटम. सो फर्दर इक्वेशन वी कैन राइट फॉर द कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एंगुलर मोमेंटम अबाउट द एक्सिस. Conservation of angular momentum about the axis. So this will give us the second required equation, because we have two unknowns. One is the radius small r and one is the speed at that particular instant. So for writing the angular momentum, we just need the distance from the axis, perpendicular distance from the axis, and that distance is basically the radius of the circle at that particular instant. So we can write like this: initially it is m v naught r, and at this instant it is m v r. So this m is cancelled, so v r is equal to v naught into r. This is the other equation, and from here we can write the value of r, small r. This is v naught r by, this is V naught R by V, and we can put this equation into this, and further we can find the value of speed. So let us put this value of R in this equation. So H by 2, and what is H here? We can also write H from here. So H by 2 is half, and this is the value of H, R square G by V naught square. So this is h by 2, and this is g here, and what is r? R is this value. This is r square v naught square r square by v square. So from here, what is going to be cancelled? This g is cancelled, this r square is cancelled, and from here we can write v raised to power 4 is 2 times v naught raised to power 4. So this is the relation between initial speed and final speed when the height is half. Now we have to find what is the work done by the pulling agent in slowly pulling. So if it is slowly pulling, then we can use the concept of work energy theorem, and from the concept of work energy theorem we can write work done by external agent on a system is equal to change in kinetic energy plus change in potential energy of the system. So work done by external, this is equal to delta k plus delta u, and whatever work is done by this external agent, this work is transferred using tension. Actually on bid, the tension is doing that work, and actually we are calculating the work done by the tension, and that work I am calling it as work done by this external agent. So whatever work is done by this external agent is transferred using this tension, and this tension is doing work on this. And due to this work, due to this external agent work, the kinetic energy is changing and potential energy of this bead is changing. So we just have to write the change in kinetic energy and potential energy, just only we have to do this. So delta k, this is half m final velocity square, this is v square, initial velocity square, this is v naught square. And what is the change in potential energy? Height is increased by h by 2. So this is mg h by 2. So let us write all the values we know. So this is half m. What is the value of v square here? So from here v square is equal to root 2 times v naught square. So this is root 2 times v naught square minus v naught square. And what is the value of this small h? So this small h is this much. So this is r square g divided by v naught square. This is the value of small h. So now we have calculated the work done by external agent in given terms. Jo bhi terms given the us terms maine calculate kar liya, bas isko just we have to arrange the terms. Now you can take this common, and now you can write this as g square r square divided by, here we will have now v naught raised to power 4, and v naught square is common here, so remaining term is root 2 minus 1. So this is the work done by the external agent in slowly pulling this bead.